prizes. We've got wacky hosts. We got me.
Yeah, who cares about me?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, weighing in at 5'9", 160 pounds, fighting out of Westfield, New Jersey, say hello to the guy in the brown trunks, Brian O'Connor.
Hey, what's up? Thank you. Thank you for showing up. Got a good show for you tonight. Live again, because that's how crazy we are. Game show, we got Elliot, Nicole, and Bruce hanging out. They're our contestants for today's show. Remember how it goes? It's a three-round deal. First round is worth 5 points. Second round is a 10-point round. We go on to the 20-point round because things get crazy later on. But we got great people for you to meet. We got a celebrity judge. We got a wacky person coming in also on the side. Keith, why don't you tell us who our celebrity judge is for today?
Oh, I tell you what, Brian. Tonight's celebrity judge passes, dribbles, and dunks basketballs. Now, I dunk donuts. You know that. Ladies and gentlemen, this guy is one tall dude. He consistently works hard, and he's a leader for the Cougs. I was a leader for my Cub Scouts division. Yeah, he's thinking about playing basketball in Chile. Why? Because he likes Chile. Say hello to David Vick, everybody.
What's up, David?
What's going on, man?
And nice to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
What's up with that passing, dribbling, and shooting thing? A passing and the shooting, I know, but the dribbling, just a napkin would clean that up, I'm telling you.
I don't know.
Look, man, how tall are you, David? How tall are you?
6'11".
Wow, that's pretty tall, man. That's really tall. That's, like, way tall. My ass probably ends where your ankle begins, basically. I'm telling you, that's how tall he is. Okay, so anyway, remember, the five-point round, the whole thing is you get the question right, you get the points. You get it wrong, you lose the points. We're going to begin right now. Ready, people? Okay. What does ET stand for? What do you got, Elliot?
Extraterrestrial.
That's right, extraterrestrial. Also could stand for extra tall, which David Vick is. I'm not, but anyway, here we go. What sports' early stunts include flip kicks, gorilla jumps, and coffins? What do you got, Elliot?
Kickboxing.
That would be incorrect. That's it. You got 5 points, you lose 5 points. You want to take it?
Gymnastics.
Gymnastics, no, that ain't the right answer either. You going to try or are you going to be safe?
I'm going to be safe.
That'd be skateboarding, of course.
Skateboarding.
Yeah. Okay. I'll wait till everybody calms down. What town does Northern Exposure tape their show in? What do you got?
Roslyn.
Roslyn is the correct answer. Roslyn, Washington. It was crazy because I was taping a little Northern Exposure myself last night. My neighbor, she does this thing in a window with the northern half. Well, never mind. Okay, in 1952, this blasphemous three-letter word magazine began publication. What do you got, Bruce?
Mad.
Mad is the correct answer. I'm glad you got that because I thought there might be some ambiguity. There was a magazine in 1953 called Ass Magazine, which basically, you know, I figured it was close, three letters. Ass Magazine. Okay. What mountain range running along Nevada's border boasts Yosemite National Park? Hey. That would be the Sierra Nevadas. The Sierra Nevadas. Cold. Okay. What was the name of the actor who played Hawkeye Pierce on MASH? What do you got, Nicole?
Alan Alda.
Alan Alda, that's the correct answer.
Yeah. Okay.
Points for Nicole. Okay. What swift-moving cartoon character's real name is Meet Meet? What do you got, Elliot?
Roadrunner.
Roadrunner, correct answer. Beautiful. What are the point totals? Can we see the point totals? Keep everybody abreast. What, Elliot's got 5, Nicole got 10. Bruce, you got 0. What's up with that, Bruce? Okay, let's get back into the questions. In the 1989 to 1990 television season, this show knocked the Cosby Show out of first place. Nicole.
Home Improvement.
Wrong, Nicole. Wrong answer. What do you got, Elliot?
Cheers.
Cheers is also the wrong answer. You going to try it, Bruce? You're going to be safe.
Be safe.
You're a good man. That's very good. It was Roseanne. Oh. Roseanne knocked it out. That's right. Okay, which one will we give you? Name, I want their full names also, by the way. Name the four Beatles. No, you don't notice?
Give me the first name.
John Lennon, Paul McCartney, Ringo Starr, and George Harrison. Huh. I mean, we would even take in Dung Beetle. I mean, really, you could have tried that. Oh.
Yeah, really.
Okay. Who sang My Ding-a-Ling?
I know that song.
You do, huh? It was Chuck Berry. Chuck Berry sang My Ding-a-Ling. And don't confuse that with Keith, our announcer, who played with his last night.
I told you not to tell anybody, Brian, you little...
Oh, Dad, I'm sorry. I got the Polaroid, so just
what
pay
I do
the
on
money
my Thursday
no
nights
problem.
Is my own business, okay?
I'm sorry, Keith. But what Burger King burger was the Big Mac created to compete against... What do you got, Nicole?
Whopper.
The Whopper, that's correct. The Whopper, sure. Keith also used to be in a porno star, did I tell you that? Just coincidentally, he starred as the Big Mac in the movie The Whopper. Hey!
Yeah.
Hey!
Didn't get that nickname, Stud, for nothing.
You're a good man, Keith.
So are you, Brian. I love you.
Oh, well, let's keep that to ourselves also. Who played Alice on The Brady Bunch? Ann Davis? Come on, people. Nothing funny about that, but anyway. Okay. In late November 1983, you were probably rushing to the store to adopt one of these dolls. Bruce.
Cabbage Patch.
That's right, a Cabbage Patch doll. I'm sorry, though. This brings back some very sore memories of me because I had a Cabbage Patch doll. And it wasn't until I brought it home that I realized that it was deformed. It had cauliflower ear. Ah! My Cabbage Patch doll had cauliflower ear.
Hey, Brian.
What?
Don't be so depressed. You know my Ken doll?
Yeah?
He decided not to be my friend.
Oh, that's hardcore. Okay. Who played Captain Kangaroo? Actually, I don't like that. Null set. Who originated Cheese Whiz? Come on. Kraft originated.
Oh, I thought you meant a man. Me too. That was bad.
All right, listen, I think we got the boat. Wait, we got time for one more question? Okay, here we go. Who did Dan Aykroyd describe as a good man but a bad boy after his death? Elliot.
Jim Belushi.
Jim Belushi's incorrect. Oh. Want to take a stab at it? Want to take a stab?
No.
How about Jim's brother? John. Belushi. John Belushi.
Nice try.
Okay, we got ourselves what we would call a bonus round here. Do we need to tell them what we're winning in this bonus round? Yeah, Keith is going to tell us what's available.
I don't know if they really want to know what they're going to win in this round, actually. But it's going to come from the country store down there on Grand Avenue. Brian had a chance to go down there, sit in all the used furniture. I tell you what, look at this chair right here. Does that look comfortable to you or what? That is pure comfort. And look, hey, this is what you're going to win. A free pig and a lamp, believe it or not. And here's Brian looking at the National Geographic. He begged a subscription last month. Couldn't really afford it anymore. And yeah, there's the pig again. We're also going to give you a fan in that chair. Could be yours with the correct answer on Gen X.
Isn't that great? Yeah. I don't know. You can sit in your chair fanning yourself while you're stroking your pig, I guess. I guess that's what's going on. Hey, look, David Vick's got the question for you. David, why don't you take it away?
Who was the only American member of Monty Python?
Okay, why don't you tell him who it was, and why don't you give him another question?
The answer was Terry Gilliam. And name one of the two WSU men's basketball walk-on players.
Matt Bortles.
Good answer.
There you go. Elliot, you won the chair, the fan, and the pig.
All right.
That's hardcore stuff. Look, I think we got to take a break. So don't you go anywhere. We'll be back after these messages.
When we come back, David Vick slams down the basketball right on Brian O'Connor's head. Should be definitely something you want to stay tuned for. We'll be right back.
ghetto